So I just received this international driving license and I did not expect to get this. I expected actually something like a paperwork, but what I received is this. I mean, I can easily eat this. It looks good. So now that I have the IDL ready, I cannot wait to get on my next trips. It's going to be absolutely amazing. Just a throwback of 10 or 20 seconds for my previous road trips. There you go. Okay, so before you go mad at me thinking how the heck I was driving for last 3 years all around the world without this international driving license, let me make it clear for all those countries where I did my road trips, they accepted my Indian driving license. They did not needed the IDL, but for my upcoming trip to Dolomites, Italy, they do not accept the Indian license. So for this, I had to just go ahead and do this IDL. So in this video, I'm gonna tell you all the details about this IDL. Let's start. Now, where to apply for this IDL, the international driving license? I actually always thought that we just can go to the RTO office, the regional transport office, and get it done. But actually, it's not true. All you have to do is just go to your RTO office, ask them for the office address where they make those IDL, because normally that's a separate office, that's not the same RTO office. You need to go to them, get the form, come back home, fill the form, go back to the office and start with the process. Now, what all documents do you need? First, you need to carry the form filled with all the details, original passport with the Xerox, original visa with the Xerox, original driving license with the Xerox, air ticket with the Xerox, 5 passport size photos and your original Aadhaar with the Xerox. Now, what is the processing time for this IDL? All it needs is just 30 minutes. You come out of their office with this IDL in your hand, just 30 minutes, nice and easy. Now what about the checklist form? The checklist form is a long form, you have to fill in a lot of details. So basically, go to their office first, get this form hard copy, start filling all the details, whatever you know. For the details you have no idea, just let it stay blank. So once you are in their office, so at least they can help you about the filling. So this is the form what you get. You need to fill this and go back to the office with the clearly detailed filled form. Now what about the form requirement? This form is actually a long form. For the first 2 pages you need to fill with all the details. This 3rd page is actually important. This is the physical fitness form. This is 2 pages and you need to go to a MBBS doctor. MBBS has to have the MBBS on their stamp. I don't know why, but that is what I was told in the RTO office. So you need to take this form to the MBBS doctor and ask him to fill all the details. He needs to do your physical fitness test, like test your eyes, test your tongue, ask about your mental illness or anything about that short, check about your cut marks and all the details. The doctor needs to fill this whole form. And the most important thing is, here in this form where you are placing your photo, the doctor has to do across signature. Half of the signature needs to be there on the photo and half needs to be out. Then pass, one stamp and one more stamp, pass. 2 stamps for the doctor. MBBS has to be written, God knows why, but 2 stamps of MBBS doctor, dum. And the whole form needs to be filled with the doctor. And you can just work with this form. Once the doctor is done, go to your RTO office and start with the process. Now, what is the IDL processing fees? It's 1100 rupees. That is what I was charged in Bhubaneswar. I guess it's same for all the states and cities. But on the website, it says 500. I don't know why, but I was charged 1100 rupees. And it has to be paid by cash. No cards, no Paytm, no phone pay, no UPI. Cash, hard cash, 1100 rupees. Keep it ready. And what about the validity for this IDL? It's just valid for 1 year once you are done with the first year, and it's valid for unlimited countries, unlimited kilometers. Once you're done with the first year, come back to the same RTO office, start with the whole process again and renew it for 1100 rupees. all again. Now, what countries can you drive with this IDL? Basically, you can drive in any of the country where you have a valid visa. This card says this permit is valid for the territory of all countries where the visa is valid. So as long as you have a valid visa, as long as you have this a card with valid 1 year validity, you can drive in any part of the world. Now the most important question, does it need an agent or a dalal or for some goose? Absolutely no. Go to the office, walk to that office with all the documents what I said and start with the process, make the payment, 1100, sit for 30 minutes, it will be done. No agent, no dalali, no goose, nothing. It's easy, super easy. Now things to know if you have the IDL. First, you always need to carry your original IDL and your original Indian driving license as well. Second, always need to carry the passport, of course, and the passport name and the IDL name has to match. Third, the IDL number and your Indian driving license number needs to match. Fourth, always carry a credit card which has the same name matching with your IDL and the driving license, because the car rental company is going to match the exact name with the booking name and then only they are going to allow you to drive in their country. So those are the things you need to keep in mind if you have an IDL and if you want to rent a car and drive around any part of the world. So that's all about IDL, guys. If you have got any questions, just let me know in the comment section below. Smash the subscribe button if you haven't done it yet and don't forget to click on the bell icon to stay updated. I will see you in my next video. Let's enjoy the outro music.